It's another spreadsheet video. Ooh, exciting. I thought I'd give you a bit of an update on how much money my solar PV and battery have saved me in the first half of this year. I know, this video is being published in September, so I'm a little bit late with this, sorry. Anyway, I'll play the intro and then let's talk detail. If you want to see details on my PV and battery installation, please go and check out the other videos on my channel. I've done a lot where I rabbit on about what does what, so I'll put some links down in the description in case you're interested. As a quick recap, I have 3.9 kilowatts of solar panels on my roof, and for the period that I collected this data, I had a Give Energy AC coupled battery with 8.2 kilowatt hours of storage capacity. Regulars on my channel will know that I've recently swapped that battery for the new Give Energy All-in-One, but that wasn't installed until July. I'm honestly not sure what I'm going to do about that in terms of presenting data to you in my next update, because it's really going to mess everything up, but I have a few months to figure that out anyway. Let me show you the spreadsheet I use to collect this data. Here is where I record each month of data. So the yellow columns are where I have to actually input the values, but all of the other columns are just calculated. It's probably easier if I show you how, an example of how I collect this data. So let's grab the data for August. If I move here, this is Home Assistant, and this is basically where I control and monitor everything I possibly can in my home, including energy consumption, and there's an actual dashboard dedicated to that here. By default, it would show you the day, but I've got it set to show you a monthly breakdown. So you can see each of these is an individual day, and there every day or bar on that graph is color coded, so you can see where the energy came from or went to. You've also got this solar production graph down here that shows you how much you generated from your solar panels. The dashed line is actually the forecast. So if you've got solar forecasting set up, it can predict what it was, but it's also useful historically. So as you can see, how much you generated compared to what was forecast that day. The most useful part of this dashboard is up here in the top right hand corner, this energy distribution section. You've got a little circle here that shows you how much you exported to the grid and how much you imported that month. You can see your battery usage down there too if you wanted. There's how much total was generated by your solar panel, so 403 kilowatt hours there for me. And then critically, this one here, home. Now that is home consumption. That's how much energy your home actually used, not what you used from solar or what you used from the grid, because if you didn't have solar panels, then all of that energy would have come from the grid. Whereas you can see there's a nice little breakdown pie chart here, and that yellow bit shows the proportion of energy that I used from my solar panels. But these values here don't actually show you how much you used off peak or on peak. So you can see I imported 371.7 kilowatt hours from the grid in August, but I don't know where that came from. Was that at peak time or was that off peak? If I scroll down a bit, you can see is a proper breakdown here of 8.2 kilowatt hours at peak and a 363 at off peak. So if I get that peak of 8.2, I can remember that, and I go back to my spreadsheet. So at peak it was 8.2 and off peak it was 363.48. I know that the rates were the same as last month. Now what was the demand value? If I switch back again, demand was 664.9, so 664.9, and then I need to know how much I exported, which was 100.4 just there, 100.4, and the rates were the same as last month as well, so the savings there of £105.72 in that month. So you can see that you don't actually need to record how much your solar panels generated in order to calculate how much you have saved, because that generation data is hidden within your home demand and how much you imported and exported. We now know how much it actually cost us in energy, so in order to know how much the solar panels and battery saved us each month, we need to know how much that energy would have cost us if we didn't have solar and batteries. The spreadsheet automatically calculates that on the assumption that you're using the same off-peak tariff. I'm on Octopus Go, which has 4 hours of off-peak energy at 12:30 every day, which makes this a nice easy calculation. If I ever switch to a more complex smart tariff like Intelligent Octopus, then things are going to get a bit trickier. Some graphs then. This first one is just to set the scene, comparing the first half of this year with the first half of last year. I'm showing my household demand for energy here, so as you can see that generally I'm using more each month, but it's still ballpark the same sort of usage pattern. I think the increased usage might be down to using the immersion heater instead of gas to heat the hot water. Okay, now this graph is a little bit of an odd one because although I had solar installed for this period last year, I didn't have the battery installed. So when comparing this year's savings against last year's, it was always going to be better this year. You can see in June 2022, there's a bit of a jump in savings because that's when the battery was installed. Now, for both years, June was the sunniest. So again, that contributes to the spike that month. But the real cause of that massive increase in savings for June 2023 is energy prices. My fixed tariff ended that month, so instead of paying about 15p per kilowatt hour at peak times, it went up to 40p. That means that every single kilowatt hour of energy that I either didn't buy from the grid at all or purchased at off-peak rates instead using battery storage means I saved a huge amount. My bill still went up because I had to buy from the grid sometimes, but overall I was massively shielded from the energy rate hikes. So the total bill saving in the first half of this year was £460.60. Added to the running total since the installation went live puts me at a saving of £1,031.06 over the 20-month period. If we now go and look at my break-even forecast, it's showing that I'm still on track to break even after the seventh year. This isn't totally true actually, the data for 2023 is real and not forecasted, and is obviously still missing a few months, so it'll probably be sooner than that. I guess the question is, do I still think that this was a worthwhile investment? Well, yes, I don't regret the purchase at all. If I didn't have this installed, then my bills would have been astronomically higher. It really has cushioned the impact of that. So if anyone is on the fence about getting solar and batteries installed, then I hope that this has helped to convince you to just do it. Anyway, I hope you found this update useful. Please give the video a like and subscribe to my channel to make sure you don't miss the next update. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.